Okay, hello free footy friends and families. Welcome to another 4 p.m. session. I hope we're live because last time, you know what happened last time, Angela, but it says we're live. So I will check it on my phone soon. Hi, Angela, how are you?
I'm good. How are you all doing?
I'm doing great. I'm doing great. I'm excited to end my week on like a high of just working out with you. I'm excited to see you. It's been a few weeks that we've seen each other. How's everything going?
Yeah, I think it's most people, we're just kind of getting used to the way things are and learning to live with it and just waiting for things to slowly be lifted and getting back to the regular scheduled program. But
totally. And you're in Toronto. I don't know if people know, but you're in Toronto, right? So a little different than Edmonton, but how's everyone been there? Like, is it still complete lockdown? Have they loosened up the rules a bit or have they tightened it up?
Well, Ontario is one of the hardest hit provinces for COVID. So the thing is, I'm not too sure if the communication has been super clear, but parks are still closed. Athletic facilities. It's funny because I think Alberta was one of the provinces at the forefront where they just shut things down for the school year and all that, whereas Ontario, I think, kept trying to be optimistic about when they can open up. But I think there was just a report that the premier here had hopes of opening things back around Victoria Day, and then shortly, like very quickly, turned around and said, no, that's not happening. So
never mind. Yeah.
And how are you guys out there?
Well, I was going to say, it's just the snow's gone. So yeah, I know, right? For us, it's like, yeah, I know. There'll be a dump at some point, but you know, it only lasts for the weekend. But yeah, right. The snow's gone. The sun has been shining. It's been like 14 degrees. There's a little bit of wind, which is okay, but it's like, you can go outside. I can now go running outside comfortably. I can go ball in my yard. You know what I mean? So, we're kind of stuck here, but at least the weather's out now. So you can do a little bit more outside.
That's good.
So I'm excited about that.
Yeah. It's been a little bit cooler here. There is an Arctic wind or something, some sort of meteorological experience that came down. So it's been kind of cold. We've been in like single digits today. It's better, but cloudy. And I think we're in store for some rain. So we just do the best that we can with what we've got.
Yeah, for sure. So what are we working on today?
If you've joined me before, then we're going to be doing some of the same again. We haven't seen each other in a little bit. So why not kind of revisit, and maybe I'll add like a couple of different drills in there. One specifically that I wanted to get to that's a little bit challenging that I haven't done in a while. So it'll be good. Yeah.
Okay.
So
cool.
Is everybody ready?
Yeah. Let's do this.
Okay. So like usual, depending on what surface you're on, I'm going to go ahead and take my socks off so I don't go slipping and sliding around. So if you want to get all ready, safety first.
Awesome.
So I don't know if anybody remembers, but we always start with our 50-step jog. We can do it in place or move around depending on what your space is. So here we go. So 50-step jog, and I'm gonna count it out. Let's make sure everybody is ready and go. 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 50.
Okay, then we're gonna move into 10 body weight squats. So either hands on head, on the hips, out in front, whatever you like most,
and just 10. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's pause at the bottom of that last one. Oh, switch it up. All right, here we go into another 50-step jog. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 50. Whew, the jogs get me. So that's good. Now we're gonna go into 10 good mornings or hinge. So remember, we can have our hands here or on our hips. We're just gonna push our bums back and get a hinge in the hip. We're gonna go for 10 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we're gonna go into, you guessed it, another 50 step jog. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 50. We're going to get upper body involved, so we're going to do an arm circle series. So what we'll do is we're going to go double arms, so both arms, 10 circles forward. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Switch to backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then we'll go single forward. So take your right arm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Switch it backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Switch arms forward. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Switch it backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The next one we'll do is just kind of our crisscross, kind of tap and back. So we'll go 10 on each, but switching over which arm goes above and which one goes below. So 10 total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There we go. Now, if you've done this before, we got our 3-point stretch. So remember, what we want to do is we're going to take our opposite arm and we're going to bend down and touch the opposite toe. And then we get a couple of jog steps and then switch where we're going. So you want your right hand to your left foot and your left hand to your right foot. Here we go. We're gonna go for 10 total. So 1, 2, 3, down, touch. 1, 2, 3, down, touch. 1, 2, 3, down, touch. 1, 2, 3, that's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So we're gonna do the same thing, but now we'll just, we call it 4-point or just double toe touch. So we'll take a couple of steps, bend down, double toe touch. Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3, that's 1. 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice. Woo! Next thing you're gonna do is just gonna stretch a little bit of a dynamic stretch. So we're just gonna take the knee, bring it to the chest. So we're gonna go 10 each side. Up, up, that's one. Up, up, that's two. Up, that's three. Up, up, four. Up, up, that's five. Six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. So here's one that I started doing more often now because as a hurdler, I'm constantly in this position to get over hurdles. So I'm gonna work the opposite direction. So we're gonna get some hip rotation in there. So we're gonna do a standing, I guess pigeon stretch, or I think sometimes they call it a figure four. So we're just gonna do the same thing as the other one. We're gonna go five on each side. Here we go. One, that's one. Two. Three. Four. Last one. Five. Woo, that one's good.
I love that stretch.
Yeah, because I don't really have... What's that, sorry?
I've never done that stretch before. Like, obviously, I've done, like, hip flexor stretches before, but to do that one, to just, like, pick up your foot, basically.
Yeah, exactly. And a lot of times you can do it once you do go outside. So if you do a little bit of a jog, so... You can jog there, take three steps, do the next foot, take three steps, do the next foot. A lot of people end up doing that drill. I've seen a lot of athletes from different sports doing that one, but it's really good. I know for me, especially because I'm always in that internal, so that to get some external rotation is always good. And we're going to finish our warm up with hip rotations.
Okay, cool.
So we're going to go 10 each direction. So whichever one you want to start with, we're going 10. So here. Just doing hip circles. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Switch directions. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Awesome.
Awesome.
I don't know if we want to bring it in for a little bit of a break. Hopefully everybody's doing okay.
I hope everyone's feeling good. I feel nice and warm. Love the 50 step jog, like in between everything. It's so
that honestly gets me.
Yeah, it's so good. Hey, I have a question actually. Have you picked up any new hobbies during this time?
I can't say I would definitively call it picked up a hobby, but at the moment my roommate and I are doing a puzzle. So a friend of mine bought us a puzzle. I talked to my aunt the other night. She's going to send me more puzzles that we can work on. And I did start two online courses, and that's why I say didn't necessarily pick up a hobby, because I've only done each course once. It's like a self-paced. So one is computer science. It's like an introduction to computer science. Oh, and then the other one is Excel, just so I can get better versed in Excel. So
yeah, that's cool. I actually love computer science. I've always wanted to. I've done a few university courses as just electives. And then I was like, I actually like this coding. And so I do some of our website design for free footing. And computer science. Love it.
That's awesome. Yeah, I want to get at least a little bit more of an introduction to it so I can understand it. But I just remember back in high school, many years ago, I took a computer science class and it was like MS-DOS, which I'm not too sure if anybody calls or uses that anymore, but it was just like a black screen with green writing. And so you'd always type in all these commands and prompts. It was all about the prompt.
Yeah.
And then I remember in my class, I think I made a happy face, like just a circle.
Wow.
That was maybe a smile.
That was a huge achievement on that thing though.
Yeah, it was a big time achievement. Actually, when I was back in Edmonton in the fall, I went and visited my high school and times have changed. They had like full Adobe suite. Like kids now, honestly, all of you kids out there, you're learning amazing things in high school that like we just never had that.
The electives that they have, like actually one of our coaches or junior coaches who goes to Ross Shep, he was saying his day starts with yoga class. And that's a credit because they actually teach you kind of like the practice of yoga, the meditation and all that. But it's like, we never had that when we were in school. So yeah, there's so many cool stuff that they're doing in high school that branches into every different kind of area, right?
Yeah, and if your high school doesn't have it, then I would suggest, like, if you're interested in those things, maybe see if there's opportunities to do that outside of school, because I'm not too sure if every school has the same resources or spends their, I'm sure some schools are a little bit more heavy on one thing versus the other. But if you're interested in that, just seek it out. There's a lot of things you can find online, like myself, computer science 50, that's what I'm taking right now. So many interesting things to learn out there.
I agree. All right, let's
get back into it. So we're going to move into some jumps. So like before, we've done a little bit of plyometric work. So we're going to start with our line jumps. So remember, we're just going to pretend there's a line on the ground and we're just going to do our forward and backs. And we're going to, let's do 25. So a 25 count, which will end up being kind of 50 touches. Okay. So remember, you have a line here and a forward and a back counts as one. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Awesome. So next one, similar, same thing, except now instead of the line being in front of us, moving back and forward, we're going to do our side line jump. Same thing. Over and back counts as one. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Nice. So next thing we're going to do is we're going to work on our vertical jumping. So we won't do the continuous ones. We're going to take single effort, vertical jump. And remember, when we jump, we don't want to anchor ourselves to the ground. We want to use our arms to help us get up into the air. Once you explode off the ground, just relax. You don't have to get tight. Use all of your effort. And then once you get up into the air, feel like you're floating and then a nice solid landing. When you land, land in an athletic stance and also try to be as cat-like as possible. So you want to make sure that we're not just like heavy on our heels, a nice soft landing if you can. Here we go. So we're going to go 10 single efforts. So up. Oh, that was a heavy landing for me. Up. Oh, that one was better. So try to get a nice soft landing. 3. Try to go as high as possible, soft landing. 4. 5. Spend as much time in the air as you can. 6. That's 7 for me. 8. I'm really working these landings. Woo! 9. One more. Yeah, that was good.
Awesome. I want to get higher.
What's that?
I said, I wish I had better vert. I want to get higher. But that's a good exercise to do.
It just takes practice so that you get the timing between the load and the spring off. Because some people will kind of go beyond and get way too, because they think the more they load, the more they're going to get on the other end. Not so, we want that stretch reflex. So you want just enough stretch to load the muscle and then be able to rebound. Once it gets past a certain point, you've kind of extinguished the capability or ability of that to move forward. So think of it explosive rather than trying to dig down as low as possible to get up.
Oh, okay. Because that's what I was trying to do. I was like, okay, come on, let's go.
Yeah, think of yourself as a spring. So if you think of a spring, a nice, strong, sturdy spring, and then think about dropping something on it, and it doesn't compress all the way down. That's kind of a loose spring. Yeah. Think of a nice, strong spring. As soon as it hits, it's going to compress a little bit and then explode or like bounce right back up. So think of yourself as that spring. So you're here, all you're going to do is load and then reverse it. Yeah, rather than down here and slow on the load, you just want to think of it bouncing and coming back up.
Wow, okay, cool. That was a great tip.
So here we're going to do something similar. We're going to jump from two and then land on one. What I suggest is don't jump as high because we are landing on one. What we want to do is be able to get that stability. So I think jumping just a little bit and then catching on one.
Okay.
As you get stronger and stronger, you can go higher and then catch on one. But I'm going to start, obviously I was jumping pretty high and landing on two. I'm not going to go that high because the stability is not going to be as great on a single leg. So we're going to go five each leg, however you want to do it. If you want to alternate or do all on one leg, up to you. So 10 total, five each leg.
Okay.
Remember, just jump as high as high enough and then catch with one leg. So up, one. Try to stick that landing, not like how I did it. One, two. Two, three. That's three on each side for me. Four. Ooh, I'm getting better. I'm getting a little bit higher on each jump. Nice. Oh. Nice. Okay.
It's this left foot, but pretty good.
Oh, that was a good one.
Yeah, that one felt good.
Yeah,
that was good.
I have a good leg and a not so good leg. Obviously, like a stronger, and I'm sure this probably happens in soccer. You probably have a more of a powerful leg versus one that's not as powerful, but.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Definitely. Nice. My right foot is dominant for me. So, yeah, my left is weak. So, but I just got to practice on it, you know?
Yeah.
But I was ask you, what is your dominant leg?
Odd.
Oh.
I would say definitely my right, but I do things differently than a lot of heptathletes. So I'll jump off of my right leg for long jump, but for high jump, I'll jump off of my left leg. Just because basketball, we always did, you learn how to do a right-handed layup, most likely, especially if you're right-handed. So I'm used to jumping that way for high jump, even though I think my right leg would be stronger, I just don't know how to coordinate it up that way. But
right leg. That's interesting.
So if I was right leg dominant, does that mean I kick the soccer ball with my right leg?
Yeah, you could.
Okay.
But
well,
like,
I know you both. You
can patient because there's some things that I can actually do very well with my left. Like when I go and take shots, I actually favor my left leg. But like dribbling or passing or doing long balls, it's like with the right. But I don't know, it's something about going to my left side and doing like my swing for my shot. I don't know what it is. So it might be the same for you where you're saying you're just coordinated on your left side for high jump. You might, yeah you just kick a ball around and see because coordination and balance is a huge thing, right? For soccer.
Yeah. So. And I have actually been spending this time since we can't get into, I'm not hurdling like I would, So I've been doing plyometrics on both sides to try to even it out, at least get some coordination, because even if we do a major movement with predominantly one side, we're bilateral. So when you run, you're going to be using both sides. So if you can work on both, and then also it helps with the brain too. If you start, say, even right with your left hand, do you know what I mean? It makes your brain, I know my coach, when I'm doing javelin things, so yeah, we're throwing, he'll make me do it on the left-hand side too, because as he says, if you have to think about it on the left-hand side, then the right-hand side is kind of like, oh yeah, like you don't have to think about it as much, but there might be certain things that you didn't actually realize until you did it with your left. Yeah,
that's so, a very good point.
Yeah.
You so maybe have to relearn of something that was so natural to you since you were a kid, right? This motion, you're like, yeah, with your right hand or whatever is your dominant. Yeah, since you were a kid. Yeah. And then to relearn something, oh yeah, for sure.
Oh, I'm so goofy. It's so goofy. Yeah. It's just like, and the whole time I'm like, I model it with my right, and I'm like, okay, I can do it on my left. And it turns so wonky, and I'm like,
you know what,
that's okay. It can look crazy, but as long as I'm doing it, people can laugh, I'm okay with that. So I think challenging yourself on both sides, even with the jumps, you're probably more balanced on the other side, so work on the balance on both sides.
Yeah, for sure.
Let's get into some of our running drills. So if anybody's either works with me or Jesse, I know Jesse Lipscomb joined you guys at one point.
Well, he did, and it cut out, unfortunately.
Okay.
Well, back on.
We'll do our running drill. So we're going to start with an A skip. So the whole point is to make sure that we're getting the knee. So we want to make sure that we're dorsiflexed. So we're pulling that toe up and we got the knee up. So we're just going to skip in place. Actually, but let's start with marches. We'll start with marches. So we're here, up and up. So we'll go 10 on each leg. That's 2. Make sure that we're using our arms. So opposite arm to opposite leg. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 1 more, 10. So that's the motion that we want. And we just want to make sure that we're kind of, to start out the skip, we're just here in place, right? And we want to make sure that we're using our arms. So as the right knee comes up, that left hand comes up. And then as we switch, we just switch both positions, right? So here we go. We're going to go 10 skips on each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, nice. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Very good. So now we're going to move to our B skip. So essentially what we're doing with our running drills, it's kind of mimicking but breaking down the running motion or the wheel, if you will, some people have called it, probably many years ago when I started track. So we've got our A, where we get our knee up. Then remember, just a little bit of an extension out front, keep that toe up, and then start to bring it so that it reaches underneath your hip. And then we just like cycle it up and then extend out. So we'll just do some marches. So on this one, we'll just go 5 per leg. So remember, we gotta use our arms too. As the right knee comes up, left arm comes up, slight extension, bring it down. That's 1. Just a little bit of an extension. We don't want to kick out. We don't want to point our toe, okay? So we're here, keep that toe up, start going towards the ground. That's 2. Up, a little bit out, start to move down and back. 3, up, a little bit out, down and back. That's 4. Up, out, down and back. That's 5. So that's it for that. Now let's move to a skip. So same motion. So let's start out with a couple of high knees, or sorry, A skips, and then start to extend out in front. Just a little bit. There we go. Let's start counting right now. 1, 2, 3, going up to 10, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10. Awesome. This next one's butt kicks. bum kicks, or we call it sometimes C. So this is just the last part of the running motion. So we've got the knee up, we start to move down to the ground, but then we need to get that back. So we usually do like a butt kick is what it's called. But really this exercise is just to kind of activate the hamstrings that were being active. So we don't want to be stabbing the foot when we do this. We want to be tapping and just moving from there. So we don't want to get that foot to cast out in front. When we do our butt kicks, this is it. That's as far as we're going to go, okay? So we're going to go 10 on each side. Ready and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I feel like we could probably go 10 more. Yeah, because that's an easy one. Let's go 10 more. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice.
Awesome.
So here's the drill that I used to do a while ago that I haven't done in a while. It's called A pause. So what we're going to do is we started in our A position, and what we're going to do, A pause, or sometimes we call it A exchange, because what we're going to do is we're going to stay in a nice strong position, switch. So all we're going to do is right knee is up, arm is up, nice relaxed upper body, but don't need to be tight. Strong in the core, making sure that we pull our ribs in. So we don't want our ribs to be out. We want our ribs to be in a solid position, okay? And then all we're gonna do is switch and pause and hold. And I'll tell you when to switch, okay? Any questions?
No, I think I got it. Can you
see me right now? Here we go. So let's start with the right knee up.
And then when you say switch, it's just—
When I say switch? Yeah. So the goal is, we want to try not to jump into it. All we want to do is boom, and then pause. Yeah, nice. Switch. Okay. Okay, so let's get ready. We're here. Switch. 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 Woo, get that balance. There we go. Switch.
Oh.
Switch. 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 One more, one more, one more. Switch and hold. There we go.
Wow. Okay.
Are the flexes burning?
Hard.
What's that? Sorry?
I was like, why was that so hard? It's just, it's balance, hey?
It's balance. It's coordination between right side, left side, up and down. And a lot of us will probably have one leg that's easier to balance on than the other, but it's that exchange in between that's like, it's really hard to get. And then also those hip flexors start to get really, really tired. The biggest thing is once they get tired, that you don't want to be here or there. Try to stay as strong as possible in the upper body. And like I said before, sometimes when people get tired, they start to scoop their back out. Yeah. So that just means that their ribs are getting pulled forward. That starts to happen. Just think about sucking your ribs so that they're over your hip bones.
Sucking them in?
Yeah, so
when
people get tired and they start to run,
we need to flex our abs a little bit.
Exactly. I don't like to say flex abs because I think sometimes people get too like this.
Okay.
So that's why I say just think about bringing your ribs over your hip bones.
Yeah, that's fair.
So we can even try that now.
Naturally flex in that position.
Yeah. So let's try that now so we know what that feels like. So think about pushing your ribs out in front. So we're here, and then all I want you to do is bring them so that they're over your hips.
Yeah.
See that position? That's where we want to be. Sometimes we don't want to get so tight and think, I need to flex my abs, because then we go overboard. We want enough contraction in there, and I think sometimes posturally, like, it's easier just to think that, rather than, I need you to flex abs, and then some people will scoop too under, so that puts their pelvis in a not ideal position either. So just stack your ribs over your hips. Nice. Okay. Let's go through that one more time.
Yeah.
We'll do that. So we're gonna shoot for 5 each leg, okay? So legs up, switch, switch, that's one, switch, switch, there we go, that's two, switch, switch. That's three. Watch your body position. Switch. Switch. That's four. Switch. Switch. That's five. One more. Just one more on the other leg. Switch. Nice. There we go. Very good.
That made me sweat.
Yeah, I'm
That made me sweat. No, that's awesome. That made me sweat. But it's just such a simple exercise, but it works everything.
Yeah. And you can sweat. If any coaches are on here, you can change it up where you go double. So you're here, you say switch, and they have to hit twice. Boom, boom, pause. Or three times. Boom, 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 pause. So you can do several.
So when you're doing your switch, is your foot completely on the ground? Or are you finding balance on your toes?
In this one, it's going to be a little bit more. I don't know if you can see my foot.
Yeah.
So it's going to be more flat. Obviously, when we're running, we're going to be on our, like I said before, in your high heel shoes, right? But for this exercise, you're going to be more of a flatter foot.
Yeah. Okay. That was cool. I just wanted to make sure that my foot was in the right spot.
Yeah.
Cool. That's awesome. I like that one. What do you call it? What did you call the challenge?
A exchange or a pause. Yeah. Sometimes what we would also do is measure out a distance. So say 10 meters and you have to go forward, a little bit forward. And then pause as you're going through.
Wow.
And what happens is a lot of people will start to jump into it. When you jump into it, you end up traveling forward more. That's not the point, to get from point A to point B in the least amount of steps. So make sure that we got good form. And then we're just switching. And you're not going to move as far forward, but you're going to get more work.
Yeah, totally. Cool. That was awesome.
How much time do we have?
What time do we have? It is 4:38. Oh yeah, we're having a great time. You want to finish? Do you have one more, or do you want to finish on that one? Because that made me work.
We could finish on that one, or what do you think about some fast foot? Well, I have some lateral drills. We could do that. Let's finish on some lateral drills because, I mean, as a track athlete, I'm pretty much this way. Yeah. But it's very important for track athletes. So if there's any track athletes on here, I know it's predominantly soccer. It's very, very important to be able to get all aspects. So working in different planes rather than just straightforward. Okay, so let's do some lateral things.
Good.
So just to kind of warm up, especially our adductors, we're just going to start with lateral lunge. So we're going to be here and down. We're going to go five each leg. That's one. Here we go. Two, so make sure that the toes are kind of pointing forward when you land. Three, if they point out a little bit, that's not too bad. Four, five, there we go.
Awesome.
So now we'll move to speed skaters. I'm not the best at this because, again, I'm very straightforward and straight back. But I do enjoy pretending that I know how to speed skate or just skate at all. So what we're going to do is go from side to side and pause. Let's try to go for 10 each leg. So here we go. One. One. Two. Two. Three. Woo! Four. Five. Six. Seven. Woo! This is burning. Eight. Nine. Woo! Ten.
Oh. I like that one.
Yeah, that one's a good one. And that you can also progress out of a pause to a more continuous.
And just keep going.
Whoa, I almost lost my footing on that one.
Oh my gosh, I know, I saw that.
Imagine if I had socks on.
Oh, you would have been, you're out. Yeah.
Yeah, I'd be out of there. So, but yeah, just know that. So for me, my foot just ended up getting a little bit too out that way rather than being on top, making sure that all the forces are going down and being caught rather than I think my body was just a little bit off the center where I could hold it. So let's go five each side, just a little bit continuous, if you have a safe space to do so. So remember that when we're landing, we just want to make sure that the upper body comes a little bit over so that we're not out, because that will cause us to skid. So we're here landing, okay? So five continuous, five on each side. One, two, three, four, five. Nice.
Awesome.
Okay,
awesome.
Last one. Okay. One more?
Yeah, let's do it.
Same thing, we've done this before. So it's just gonna be a one, two, three, pause, and pushing to the side. So we're gonna start here. One, two, three. One, two, three.
Okay.
One, two, three. Okay. So we're gonna go 10 each leg. Yeah, 10 each leg. Let's finish it off well, everybody. Here we go. One, two, three. One, two, three. That's one. Two. Three. Four. Five. Five more. Let's go. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Keep your legs moving fast. There we go. Whew.
Yes. That was awesome. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no worries. So my only reminder is that we haven't done a cool down, but hopefully people are doing a cool down after they do this, because cool downs are really important to help us kind of kick into our recovery after a workout. So
cool. Well, what is your cool down? What do you usually do?
Well, I'm going to be honest. I used to cool down always. It used to be, and then as years went on, and it's like, I got to get out of here. I've got something else going on. I've got work. I have not, which is terrible. But for a cool down, you can either do like an easy, same kind of jog, maybe, but this time, instead of doing a 50-step jog, do a time jog. So just kind of, but not as intense. We're trying to do now is bring the levels down. So we're decreasing the heart rate and everything. And then, so we just easy jog. And then, in all honesty, you could do it like a, kind of like a quick hit yoga routine, some stretching.
I was gonna say,
stretching is really, really good.
Stretching wouldn't be bad, right?
No, and I know like some people talk, there's some misunderstanding about static stretching as far as, but after a workout, static stretching is really good. Kind of keeps that, the length, not only in the muscle, but the connective tissue. I think that as you get older, I'm warning you all, when you get older, the connective tissue, so ligaments and tendons, they start to kind of feel a little bit wonky. So admittedly, not going to lie to anybody, I can always do a better job with cooling down. And maybe that's the promise I should make myself, is to, no matter what, even if it's later on, say if you're busy, you can't get it done right away. As soon as you can, it's best. But if it's later on, as long as you're doing something, getting some easy stretching. So something for the quads, something for the hamstrings, maybe just pick. Don't make it a big ordeal where we have to go through this big routine, especially if you don't have time. Don't worry about it. Pick one stretch for each major muscle group. So quads, hip flexors, glutes, hamstrings, calves. If you want to do some like ankle rotations or something, then the biggest thing also, which I need to be a better participant in, is breathing. So as you're doing this, just take those breaths and kind of feel that calm, because say if you're in a shootout, you can use that skill where you come and center yourself and ground yourself. And my biggest thing is you want to ground yourself without being anchored. Ground yourself so you feel in control of what you're doing, but not anchored that you can't move anywhere, right? So that's what those breathing, so nothing special. If you want to find a breathing tool somewhere online, all that's all great, but it could just be as simple as just calming things down, feeling really good.
You feel it, right? You feel the breath go through you. You feel the air go through you, and then you feel it come out. That's when you're being just so mindful.
I always forget how much deep breathing and just calm, centered breathing is. And I think a lot of us, we're always here, like everything's so tight.
Yeah.
But the diaphragm is huge when it comes to physical activity, not just for breathing, but just kind of like positionally, strength-wise. So make that diaphragm work the way that it should, because we don't, I think, on a regular basis, because we're so uptight and the breathing is shallow. So
yeah, great tips. Great tips. Stretching, breathing, totally important. You know what? I do my stretches when I go for dog walks, and I'm like, if I'm at a dog park and my dog's just running around, I will just stand there and I will touch my toes like 10 times. And then, or I will do squats, or I just stretch in the middle of a park and everyone's like, what are you doing? Stretching.
Yeah. I know a lot of coaches would always say, if you're at home and you're watching a TV show, this was back in the day when we couldn't binge watch anything, like there were commercials. So like stretch during the commercial, but you can always find a little routine. And the biggest thing is find a routine that works for you. And then you can add to it, take away from it, depending on what your time frame is. You can switch it up if you start to get bored, but find something that's solid that you know that you enjoy that works well. Trying to hit up all the major groups. Oh, upper body as well. Don't forget arms, shoulders, all that stuff. Cause I always focus on lower because track, but
everything. That's awesome. Yeah. Thank you so much, Angela. I had fun hanging out with you. Let us know how this puzzles go. Is it like a 4,000 piece puzzle?
No, it's just simply a 1,000, but who knows? We might actually work our way up to one of those ones where it has no picture. It's just all one color.
Yeah. Okay.
Where there's no edges.
Yeah, that's
there's
cool.
No edges. It's just like circular or something.
Yeah. So you have no idea. Like, yeah, there's no
or
way.
Or the color gradient ones where the color starts to kind of change.
Yeah, that one's
those ones. We might work our way up to that, but we'll stick with the 1,000 boost. Yeah. Well, thank you all
for your puzzles.
Pardon me?
I'm said I'm going to keep my eye out for your puzzles.
Yeah, I might be able to find some, but a lot of places are sold out online. So
yeah, it's been crazy. Anyways, I hope you guys all had fun with us. We won't be doing live shows over the weekend. We're going to take a couple days off to relax, enjoy the sun, and then we'll be back Monday. But I will be putting out lots of highlights from this past week's sessions on our Instagram and our Facebook page. Our YouTube channel's up, so all of our videos are there. I have all the links posted on our Facebook page, so go check it out. Thank you, Angela. Thank you,
Thank
everyone,
you.
For joining in. We'll see y'all later. Bye.